Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, to the world away, and God I love new build day. We have got a brand new release from a brand new company called Fanhome. We have now got Dominic Toretto's Fast and Furious Dodge Charger. Now, if you're not sure who Fanhome are, I've put links to their social media just down the bottom here. And to be honest with you, it's the social media that pricked up my ears and my eyes straight away when they come up with one of the taglines, which I thought was a brilliant quote, which says, "We exist to make fandom stories you love last forever." In fact, their mission statement is to inspire fans with innovative content, high quality build-up models and exclusive collections, and that is exactly what we're going to be looking at today. I've had a quick look through this brochure and God, it impressed me. Now, I'm not sure if you've seen the Fast and Furious franchise, but the Dodge Charger plays pretty pivotal role through the whole saga. It's actually featured in the first film, it's actually shown during the middle of it and then driven at the end, which is a brilliant bit. If you haven't seen it, I'm not going to tell you what happens, but the car is not featured again until the fourth film, Fast and Furious. So it's pretty much continues through the saga after that. Absolutely brilliant vehicle this is, and that's what we're going to be doing today. We're going to be building stage one of the first pack here. I'm going to show you everything that you get in stage one, and we're going to build that together. We're actually going to be building the bonnet and the supercharger, which goes on top of the bonnet as well. Now, once again, if you want to get this for yourself, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a link down here. You've also got a discount code. Now, the discount code is going to get you the first issue for 99p and the next three issues for half price. Also, if you order before the 20th of January, you can get yourself a free cap and t-shirt on that side there, and I'm probably going to get one of them as well, because I like to have t-shirts when I'm building the builds to show you what I'm actually building. But head on over to the website now to order that. If you follow that link there, it is case sensitive, or alternatively just click on the description, it will take you over to the Fanhome website. By following that link, it just says that you've come from the World of Wayne YouTube channel. Anyway, let's show you what we've got in the first stage. So the first magazine we get looks just like this, and this is the brochure of the build. And as you can see, you've got some lovely editorials in here, pictures of the Dodge Charger. We've also got a centerfold, and I like a centerfold. Basically, this tells you all about the vehicle and what it does. We've got working lights, we've got opening doors, opening trunk. As you can see, the specs of the vehicle, it's 68.5 centimeters long, 24.4 centimeters wide, and 18.1 centimeters high. It's weighing 8.3 kilograms. Just continuing to turn here, just shows you about what to expect from the build guide, and that's what we're going to look up at the moment. So in each stage you get a magazine, which is good, and in the magazine, once again, it tells you all about the car we're building and all about the Fast and the Furious franchise, and then it goes into the build. And as you see, in the first build we're going to be doing the bonnet and the supercharger. Now, you do get a screwdriver in pack one, and you get step-by-step instructions exactly how to build this and put this together. But I will be putting the instructions on the screen as I build it, like I do with all my other videos, just so you can follow along so you can see what I'm doing. But looks pretty interesting and impactful with the first stage. Really gonna make this vehicle come along already, because we're gonna have pretty much the whole top front of the section completed just in pack one. Then we've got some more details about how they used to tune and supercharge cars. And we get that pretty much in every magazine we've got. Now, that's issue number one. Coming to the channel shortly, we're going to have, as you can see here, in no order, issue four. We've got issue three here. And if I give you a quick tease at issue two, just so you can see what's coming here. Again, some more details about the Dodge Charger there, and then we're going to be doing the wheel rims here with, again, step-by-step instructions, so you'll be able to complete this quite easily and build this up yourself. Now, if thinking about how big the vehicle is going to be, 68 odd centimeters, I hope I've got room on that shelf for it. It's going to be a very big vehicle, but this is going to be an absolutely brilliant build. With the black of the Dodge Charger, it's certainly going to pop when it's on the back on the shelves there, but I'm itching to get on with this. So without further ado, let's get cracking. So I have zoomed my camera out just so you can see everything that we've got in pack one. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to open this and lay everything out so we're ready to start the build. And there we go, that's what it looks like when it's all opens. Look at the sheen on this metal. It's absolutely brilliant. Now, as I said, it does come with its own screwdriver. The screwdrivers you want to use have got a Phillips head, and they are PHO size screwdrivers. I do use my own one for this. The reason being is I do like the extra length on the screwdriver here just to get to those fiddly spots. So I'm just going to put this to one side. Now, to start with, I'm going to put a towel down looking just like that, because we're going to be working on the bonnet. This is what the bonnet looks like. It's fully metal. Look at the finish of the paint on that. And that's what it looks like from this side. We actually want this side because we're actually going to be putting the underside of the bonnet on first. And this is what the underside of the bonnet looks like. Just like that. This is plastic. It's actually going to follow the template that we've got on here. So quite simply, it's going to be going over the lugs that you see in this section here. And we're just going to drop that into place just like that. Now, it's going to be held in with 9AM screws. Now, the screws all come in this. They all come in bags just like this. And as you can see, they are labeled so you can see what screws you've got. So these are the AM ones. I'll get these open and we'll start screwing these in. Now, when I screw into metal, I do like to put just a little bit of oil on the screw here because there's going to be paint in these little thread holes here. Just helps the screws go in lovely and smooth. So here's the first one in, just on this side over here. We'll put the second one just over this side over here. Make it as tight as you can get it. The third one is just going to be in the front here. Just like that. The fourth and fifth are going to be in these ones just here. And then we've just got the four at the back, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So there we go, they're almost all in. We've just got this one down the end here. Once again, just screwing that in here. So when that's in, all 9 screws in like that. So from the top, it's looking like that. From underneath, it's looking like that. So we can put that to one side because now we're going to start working on the supercharger. And these are the two parts of the supercharger we need now. As you can see, this is chrome plated plastic, absolutely flawless finish on it. And we obviously need the intakes for the supercharger there. Now, quite simply, these are just going to go into here like that, over the two screw holes that you can see in here. And that's going to be held into place with BP screws. Now, normally on these screws, if it ends in a P, it means you're going into plastic. And if it ends in an M, it normally means it's going into metal. And as I did say just earlier, that if it goes into metal, I do tend to put just a little bit of oil in there to help the screw in. I don't need to do it on this section because this ends in a P, so it's going into plastic. But that looks just like that. And that's what it looks like from the front there. Now, I could put that to one side because we're going to be working on the butterfly flaps now. And basically what we want to do is we've got a longer end on the spindle for this and a shorter end on this one. So with the longer end towards our right here on my right hand side, I'm going to press these flaps into place. Now on one side, absolutely brilliant painted these are. You can see it's completely plain. On the other side, there is a down arrow. What we want to do is we want to put the down arrows facing us when we put this on. So I'm just going to push this onto the spindles like this. So here's the first one. Now you might find it easy to actually put the face down and push this part detail onto it just like this. It'll just keep everything into place. And as you can see, when the first one's on, the down arrow's on there looking just like that. We're going to repeat it for the other two, making sure they all go on exactly the same way. Here's the second one, pushed into place. And that's the third one on. I'm just making sure everything's flat, so it should look like that from that side and that from that side. Now we're going to be putting the butterfly spindle into place. And as you can see, we've got two little brackets here and the other side just over here. We're going to drop this in this way around so the down arrows are facing away from us. So when we actually look at this through the front of the supercharger there, we're just seeing the plain vents there. Once again, I can put that to one side because we just need the other sections for the supercharger housing now, which is this section here and the bracket looking just like this. Now with the bracket facing down, so the lugs here are pointing down, we're just going to put the top section here over the top to line up these holes here with the holes that we can see in here, just like that. Now all of these are going to be held in with AP screws. And we'll get these screwed in. These are screwed in just into these holes. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'll put these in now. Now we're going into plastic. You don't have to put them too tight. Just tight enough by the hand. You don't even need to put really much tension on them as well. So as soon as it goes tight, just give it one more tiny turn until you can't turn it anymore with your hand loosely. Two at the back here. There you go. And one here. Now I am working on a really soft cutting mat. So if I thought there's any danger of me scratching this chrome, once again, I would have put down a towel for that. But that should look just like that. Now we're going to bring over the supercharger, what we were working on before. And quite simply, this is just going to piece all of this together. It's also going to hold in the flaps that we just installed. So when this is in, it's going to look just like that. As you can see, you've got the flaps in there, which are able to turn still, just like that. This looks really good. Now this is held in with just four screws into the holes that we haven't put anything in at the moment. So here's the first one. One there. Put one just on the other side here. And then we've just got the two smaller ones just in front of it here. One there, and one just on the other side here. So now that is looking really good, isn't it? Like that. So the next thing we want to put on are these tiny parts here with the throttle levers. Now this is the right side of the supercharger, this is the left side here. All we've got to do is just push the throttle lever just over the spindle that we created there, just like this. So that's going to go in like that, and it's going to be upright. And then just over the top of that, we've got the linkage, which is a slightly bigger section here, which is just going to go over the top. This goes this way around. If I push it on first, it's probably better to show you how this looks. Just like that, with the detail facing down there. And then on the left side of the supercharger here, we just want to put the other throttle section on. Just like that. So when they're all completed, they should look just like that. Now we're going to attach the fuel distributor, looking just like that, just onto the screw that we can see at the back of the supercharger there. That's going to go on just like this. Once again, it's going to be held on with an AP screw. So I'll just hold that into place as I put a screw in here, making sure that that's perfectly square in there like that. Then we're going to take the pulley spindles here, the two parts of it, we're going to join these together. And basically the lugs on this side are going to go onto the back of this section here. So when you put it on, it will fit pretty flush in there like that. But it's going to be held in on the other side just with two AP screws into these holes here. So I've got those screws here, let's get those ones in as well. There's a lot to do in stage one, isn't there? So you can see what I mean by just giving this a try and seeing what you think of this, because at the moment I believe it's 99p, but just going to tighten this one up as well. So there we go, that should look just like that. Then on the back of the spindle, in these two holes here, we're going to be putting this bracket. It's going to go on this way with the flat side up, so the fork side is facing down. Once again, that's going to be holding with two AP screws. That's the first one in. Let's put the other one in on the other side here, then I'll tighten them both up. There's the second one. Tighten the first one up. So that's now the bracket in place. And then we're going to take the blower case, looking just like this. We've got two slots in there. They're going to accommodate the two slots that we've got in here. We're going to push that together so it fits perfectly flush, just like that. And it's going to be held in with two AP screws just on the inside there. That's the first one in. One more. And there's the second one. So that's looking just like that now. Then we're going to be assembling the drive pulley here, which looks like that, onto the spindle on the end here, making sure it's this way around. So when we put it on, it's going to be like that. Once again, this is going to be held in with an AP screw just down the end there. Make that nice and tight. There we go, and that's the spindle on then. Just going to put the three lugs together just like this. That's the back two, just do the front one as well, in like that. And there we go, that's the supercharger on and in place there. The lugs actually hold themselves in, so I could turn that upside down and nothing's going to happen. Now you've got my fingerprints on this, so let me just polish that up a little bit. Just use my just move my cloth here just so you can see how shiny this chrome is. See, I take pride in my work here, but that is looking absolutely brilliant. Look at the shine on that. And there we go. And that's the, as you can see, you can open and close, no problems at all. Looking just like that. And that is all there is to do in this stage. So in this stage, as you can see, we've done the bonnet. The supercharger is actually going to fit in there kind of like that. So that's going to give you an idea when that's mounted on top of the engine, how that's going to look. But pretty impressive for what you get in the first stage. You know what, out of every build I think I've ever done, the most I've ever done in issue one, I've just done right now. And it looks really impressive. I do love the shine on it, but I do think I am gonna have to keep my polishing cloths here to keep my fingerprints off things, because at the moment, using oil and stuff, you may need to make sure that you don't get it all too much on the plastic, otherwise you'll be spending forever trying to clear it off. But it looks really good, really good. As a matter of fact, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick this up to just give you an idea of size. That's what it looks like. Look at the reflections in that. That's what it looks like. And that's what you do in stage one. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, once again, I said, if you order by the 20th of January, you can get yourself a free cap and a t-shirt, but just follow the link that we've got down here. As I said, we do have a promo code, which I'll put over here. Just follow that promo code. You do that at checkout, you'll be able to input that, and that will give you the first issue for 99p and the next free for half price. So I really do love this, and I'm really looking forward to see some of the future things that Fanhome are going to be bringing out, not just part builds, but for collections as well. So I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.